Yes, good morning students. I am Dr. Gopal Krishna Yamagamkar, Associate Professor of Economics, GFDC Center for PG Studies, Tengkin UDP. Today I am going to take or teaching the cycles theory of profit. Of course, this particular topic is in microeconomic analysis, second of MA Economics, second semester of Mangalore University. So dear students, we have already studied, of course, some theories of profit. It will be innovation theory of Schumpeter, or it will be uncertainty theory of Knights. Of course, majority theories regarding to profit took one or the other reasons for the profit. And as you know, Schumpeter said it is because of innovation, and Knight, of course, he said it is because of uncertainty. Of course, that may be true also in certain extent. In addition to that, of course, recently another economist who gave theory regarding the profit, that theory is called as, of course, by his name, the Shackles theory of profit. So I would like to teach in detail this particular theory. I hope that you are going to follow me properly. So Professor G.L.S. Shackle has extended Knight's theory of profit by introducing expectation under conditions of uncertainty. Already I said Knight has given the uncertainty theory of uncertainty regarding to profit. Has this particular GLS cycle, of course, is the external form of the same theory, and he uses another word, another concept that is called as expectation. Of course, this expectation under uncertainty conditions. Of course, every moment on every respect, economic conditions are always uncertain, that we can't able to predict exactly what is going to happen. Certain percentage that you can say it may happen like this. So an entrepreneur, of course, he is going to expect something change in the system. According to Shackle, expectations are of two types. One is general expectations. Of course, this general expectation relate to variables general to the economy as a whole. The change that happens, the whole economy, they are associated with future macro variables. Here I have given the one or two examples, that is general price level. Of course, it is applicable to whole economy. Gross national product, GNP, again it's whole economy. And balance of payments, again it is the whole economy. Like that, number of such variables are there, and that changes. So an entrepreneur should have some expectations regarding this one. This is general expectations. Next one is the particular expectations. Of course, particular expectations relate to variables to a firm or industry. They are associated with such micro variables as the future reaction of a particular marketing strategy adopted by a firm, or a future pricing policy of a competitive firm, etc. Remember, this is related to a firm or industry. So this particular thing is most important one. Of course, this is again related to the micro variables. It is not the whole economy, it is related to a particular firm industry. Both are, of course, depending upon two very important things here. One is subjective certainty. This is the thing that I have to discuss a little. Subjective certainty, of course, business committed decisions are based on general expectation, because there is subjective certainty in case of general expectation, and time horizon is only 12 months. What is this? General expectations. I already classified two conditions. One is general expectation, second one is particular expectations. Business committee, they are very certain about the general expectation, because you know, fiscal policies and different type of policies of the government, majority of the time that these policies, of course, have a time horizon of 2 months, I mean for 1 year, as you all know that. So they can anticipate price and income increase correctly for the economy as a whole. Proper anticipation leads to high investment and windfall profits. Whenever these businessmen, of course, expect particularly properly, or the anticipation is perfect, then the economy definitely will grow, and there will be high investment and there will be profits, and everything is going to be positive. Of course, this is possible also because policy is always for 12 months and all. So whatever the tendency, they can able to judge without any difficulty. That is subjective certainty is possible. Let's come to the subjective uncertainty. So here, of course, the second most important things in respect of that we have to discuss a little. It is possible to particular expectations. See, I said industries here, it is related to the particular expectations. Subjective uncertainty is more in the particular expectations. The time horizon is quite long, ranging between 100 to 150 months. Remember that, how many years it is going to be. So here, a firm or an industry may earn either innovative profit or monopoly profit depending upon its policies and competitors. It's the most important thing that you should remember, because here, if an industry properly expect, say, what is going to happen, of course, it's a long-term process. It's quite a long-ranging. See, 100 to 150 months means it is more than 3 to 4 years, like that. Of course, every industry, they should have their own gestation period, their own plan, their own ideas for investment and all these things. If you want to earn a profit between these years, then they have to go for innovative type of things. So they may earn some profit in that conditions, and they may change their policies, of course, compared to the competitor's policy. Under perfect competition, a firm with innovations, with new products or new techniques can earn innovative profit. It's possible in the perfect competition. On the other hand, when there is monopolistic competition, then we can't go for any type of innovations as such, because product differentiation is one of the most important features of the monopolistic competition. So they have to think about marketing policies which leads to profits. Marketing policy means they can think about the advertisement, and they can think about some other designs and all these things, thereby they can able to increase the profits. When the time horizon is quite long to earn profit, right decision is necessary. Remember that here is a little bit big. That is why the decision should be very, very precise and should be very decisive or very important. Determinate type of decisions is very much important. So now I'm going to further with the things, because majority are individual firms, they have to take the decisions, and there is the uncertainty conditions, and that ultimately decides the profits of the particular company, and all these things are very important. So you have to discuss a little about the subjective uncertainty, because under subjective uncertainty, profit depending upon correct decision by the firm. It is already I discussed a little. So who takes the decision then? In the firm, who is going to take the decisions? Of course, say every firm is having its own departments. Okay, all their departments are going to give their own ideas, feedbacks, and all these things, their suggestions. That suggestions will consolidated, and the entrepreneur of the firm is going to take the decisions. So what is the base for to take the decision? The base is weighing the evidence, because there are definitely every particular industry is going to appoint an economist, and economist is going to recognize it as economist analyst. He is going to bring the world data, that is the evidence for them, and by data they are going to come out with some conclusions and decisions, and that's some inferences. That inference is going to help them to take the decision. So they're weighing the evidence. So this is what called as, of course, the total things depends upon the ultimately when the evidence is given, and there's a lot of the old ideas and old I mean old instances the datas and everything is there, evidences are there, it doesn't mean that they have to take this decision, that decision. So that will definitely influence on the psychological matters of the decision maker. So this is what ultimately decide depending upon the psychological matters of the person. So that's what it is called as psychological approach too. The entrepreneur formulates hypothesis on the basis of these type of ideas. So what will be the outcome then? As per the Shackle is going to have some hypothesis. What are those? He imagines a neutral point to the right of which he places those hypotheses that are pleasing. And just imagine, it's a again need to imaginations here to the students. So imagine there is a I have a diagram for that also. I will show the diagram a little bit later. And before that, see the things. If you just imagine there is a one particular point, it's a neutral point, and the right side, of course, which he places those hypotheses that are pleasing, and the left of it is those that are undisplacing. Of course, if you have some hypothesis on the left side, that's going to be displeasing. Displeasing means it's not going to be pleasant, and the right side is the pleasant. So the right side, all pleasing or displeasing consequences that are close to the neutral point appear very pulsable, and I have a low degree of potential surprise. Remember that when this particular pleasing or displeasing consequences, which are near to the neutral point, of course, it is not very pulsable, and it's I'm sorry, it's a very pulsable, and they have no potential surprise. Potential surprise, in the sense, if there is potential surprise, either there will be loss or there will be gain. That is a potential surprise. Otherwise, if it is far away, then sorry, if it is near to the neutral point, there is a very little chance of loss or very little chance of gain. That is why there is not much potential surprise in that sense. Or more pleasing or displeasing hypotheses that are moving away from the neutral point on both directions have a growing degree of potential surprise. See, whenever we are away from this neutral point, maybe the right or left, it may be pleasant or unpleasant, or it may be pleasing or displeasing. So if it is you are away from the either side, then there is a chance of potential surprise. Potential surprise may be positive or may be negative. It depends upon the decisions which you have taken. Thus, it is a combination of pulsability, and it is related to pleasantness and unpleasantness. This is the neutral point, and already said the this side, particularly right side, is a pleasing, and this particular side is displeasing. And at the end of this, there is a focus gain and there is a focus loss. We will discuss about that things. Just see the diagram here. This right side is a pleasing and the left side is a displeasing. Of course, this is not a diagram, is available in the internet or elsewhere or in the books also. It is created by myself. So for to make to understand the result, it's a focus gain and focus loss. See, what is that focus gain and focus loss here? When the end, of course, you understood the diagram, the right side and left side very carefully. When the entrepreneur moves towards the right of the neutral point, the hypothesis grows in pleasantness faster than it grows in impulsibility. But after a point, the increasing pleasantness upsets the increasing impulsibility of the hypothesis. Ultimately, there is a fit. Hypothesis on the pleasant side, it is called focus gain. Remember that? Here it is very clear. If the unpleasantness is O2 or it is lesser than the pleasant, then automatically you will go to the some peak points, that is what called as the pleasant side. It is called focus gain. When the entrepreneur moves towards the left of the neutral point, the hypothesis grows in unpleasantness faster than it grows in pulsability. See that if you move the opposition side, opposition direction, that means left side, then definitely there is unpleasant side. But after a certain point, the increasing unpleasant upset the increasing pulsability of the hypothesis, and ultimately there is again the fake hypothesis on the unpleasant side. It is called as focus loss. See, if you move faster than that side, I mean left side, then there is a chances of focus loss. If focus gain exceed the focus loss, see, just remember these things. If focus gain exceeds the focus loss, entrepreneur's positive decision, which helps to increase investment and from profits. If focus gain is exceeds focus loss, then there is a future for the future. In the sense, there will be some profits, then investment will increase. Of course, there is a reverse case also. There is a vice versa case also. If focus gain is less than the focus loss, or otherwise focus loss is more than the focus gain, then automatically there is a chance of some problem in the systems, and the decision is not good for the this particular firm, and that firm may decrease. Otherwise, they may think twice for the changing the investment policy, because there may be less profits, or there may not be profits, and also there is a chance of that, whatever it may be. So if it is if you move to the left side faster than the right side, then there's a chance of that things. Remember it, according to Shackle. Thus, in Shackle's theory, the entrepreneur decision making is neither irrational nor whimsical. Rather, than it is based on his intuitive perceptions. Remember that, of course, every businessman should have an intuitiveness. You may be in any type of business for that matters, because I in the beginning itself I said we can't able to exactly predict what is going to happen in the business or in the economy tomorrow. That is why you should have an intuitiveness. If you have, of course, evidence and your analysis, everything is always there in the background. However, that is not the ultimate. That you can't say that it is happening like this only in the future in the economy. So there is a lot of other things that influences on the economy, and that is why we can't able to predict. But intuitiveness, every person would like to have some intuitiveness and perceptions regarding the future. That helps to either gain or loss sometimes, every time. Anyhow, Shackle's theory, this psychological theory, of course, definitely try to give new direction to the profit theory, and this is the new ideas he has presented also. But this theory is also criticized by some economists, because I already said this particular theory is somewhere else brought some elements of nice theory of uncertainty and some theories of Schumpeter's, some elements of Schumpeter's innovation too. So that is why this is not the original theory, and of course this, again, this is based on the psychological, because people are always thinking that if the theory is based on the psychological matter, it is not so contended. In other words, it is not so strong, it's not so real. That is why psychology may change. That is also possible, and it may change from time to time and place to place, and all these things are there. That is why some people, they against to that. The Kirsten too said Professor Shackle himself uses the device of introspection effectively, but introspection can allow him to discover how he makes a decision. It cannot tell with any certainty how an entrepreneur or a board of directors makes a decision. Of course, this is again the psychological related matters, and definitely there will be some problems in this respect. That is why some economists, they said, no, it is not possible, because this theory is not going to give you real solutions or real ideas regarding the profits of the systems. So that's why we have to reconsider the things and all. So whatever it may be, this is the new directions, new type of idea he has given to the profit theory. And this is the, of course, latest theory that you're going to study about profits. And it's a very, if you start to say logically, then probably there may not be problem in this particular theory, because you start with the uncertainty conditions and the expectations, and followed by we switch it over to the particular expectations, and particular expectations, of course, related to the company and how they are going to take it for the focus gain and focus loss, and ultimately how we're going to decide the investments and all these things in the systems. Anyhow, thank you, students. If you have any problems in regarding to this particular theory, you can contact me and you can discuss with me without any hesitations, because this is time for conclusions. Thank you and all.